your schedule variance, I'm on page 226. Page 226. I'm on, so you can do schedule variance and schedule performance index. We are introducing this topic now, but we will study this in detail in the next knowledge area, which is control cost, which is cost management knowledge area. There we'll do not just schedule variance, but also cost variance. Not just schedule performance index, but also cost performance index. If you are living in the agile world, how do you control the schedule? Through something called a burndown chart. Burndown chart. Burndown chart is a concept that specifically, I'm on page 226, that specifically relevant to the agile world. How many people are hearing that word for the first time? I know Bahrain and Deba are. How many other people, Senthil, also hearing it for the first time, burn down chart? Senthil, remind me your background.
I'm a software engineer.
Software engineer?
I'm doing a technical team.
Okay.
And we're doing kind of mixture role.
Okay, mixture. Yeah. Yeah.
It's a pretty fine.
So have you guys have you worked on any agile team, scrum team?
Actually, we follow certain agile and scrum, but there's no kind of standard to find the protocol.
Makes.
And of course, we go into sprint plan.
Oh, you do.
Okay.
So the word iteration is the same as sprint. You know, so they've used the word in sprint burn down chart or iteration burn down chart. And Smriti, you've heard burndown chart before?
No.
No, even you haven't heard burndown chart before. Okay, so what happens in a agile sprint? Sprint means starting on day one, and for 14 days, we'll work on some requirements, and we will implement those requirements, is what happens in 14 days. And imagine it's a 14-day sprint. I start off with 40 requirements. Let's say 40 requirements. So what should happen as days go by? The outstanding requirements should go down. Would you agree? Right? I start off with 40 things to do, and as I go through the days, the work remaining should go down. That means work is being done. If this line, this is how it should be ideally. This is how it should be ideally. But will you be doing the exact same amount of work every day? Not possible. Some days you'll achieve more, some days you'll achieve less. So in reality, your work may progress like this. Sometimes more, sometimes less. So this is the actual, right? The amount of work remaining is going down at a different pace than ideal, right? What happens if day after day you see this line staying horizontal? What would mean? What would that mean? Something is wrong. You know, no requirements are being delivered. Right. So I've sort of simplified this by saying requirements. In reality, these are what we call story points. Story points, where each requirement has a certain amount of story points, and story points is a way to measure how much effort is each requirement. So that's what a burn down chart is. A burn down chart is nothing but a simple way of showing how much work remains versus how many days have passed, so that as the days progress, you hope that the work remaining goes down.